Good morning to all students. It is my pleasure to welcome today's guest, Mrs. C.G. Anubhava from SRM Institute of Science and Technology, Pattankulathur campus. She has vast experience in the field of software engineering, particularly in software testing. And she is working as a faculty member in the Department of Software Engineering in SRM. I request Mrs. Anubhava to hand over this, to take the session on insights on software testing. I hand over the session to Anubhava.
Thank you, Srinivasan. It is a great pleasure that you have invited me for this guest lecture for insights on software testing. So I'm extremely thankful for the university for inviting me and the students who have joined for this session. So I hope I'll make the session a very useful one so that you get a brief overview of what you've learned over through this semester. So students, I really request you to be a little more active because I'm going to give you a small exercise, and we can include even your professors for playing a game to understand whether we are able to find the bugs and errors, you know, are we a very good testers or not, right? Are we ready for the session? So here I'm going to present. You can, sir, as per my knowledge, the students can use the chat, right, to put their answers and all. Suppose I ask a question.
Sure, madam. They will use it.
Yeah. Okay. Even if the students want to answer it in through the mic, I think you can use this facility. Please feel free to unmute yourself. And if you want to answer whenever I'm asking you a question, you can even make sure that you answer by unmuting. Okay. So here I go with your presentation. Just a second. I think I'm faced. One second, just a second. My presentation visible?
Yes, madam.
Okay, thank you. I'm so sorry. Just there. All right. So it's a very regular practice that we start our presentation with a very auspicious thing. We say we should start with a positive note and all, but being a software tester and being your coming from a software testing background, I would always say an auspicious thing for a tester to start is with the bug, right? So what's a favorite bug and what, how things can go wrong, and I want things to go wrong so that I can make it correct, right? So that's the reason I'm going to start today's presentation with some case studies which we should know that why software testing has become a very efficient one in the present future. So have you heard about so many failures which has happened in the past and all? So today I'm just going to first start off with a small overview about that. The first one was a Yahoo data breach. So how many of you students know that this is one of the very epic failure that happened. That is during September 2016, there was a breach in the Yahoo which exposed around 500 million credentials that was in a span of 4 years. Whatever the data was collected in the span of 4 years, the data breach has happened and the credentials were leaked in the month of September 2016. And the company, they tried to prove that they were trying to going on to say that it was a breach which was created because of the state which had sponsored this fund, and it was done on behalf of the government where this hack was performed. But fortunately, it also made sure that it said that the passwords and the security questions were not leaked. That is, the financial data was not breached, but only the credentials were leaked, and they requested all the users to change their username and password. So that was one of the major breach which happened. The second one was am I audible?
Yes, madam. You go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. If you feel that my voice is not audible, please let me know so that I can correct myself. Okay. The second one which I wanted to mention was about the thermostat freeze. Now, if you see most of the the cold places in like the foreign countries and all, they used to use this thermostat to increase in the room and keep them warm. But then this Nest smart thermostat, which was owned by the Google, it went wrong literally, and the rooms were not getting it was not getting heated up, and it left the rooms with very cold, and the customers were not able to heat their homes. And hence when Google went on and checked what went wrong with the thermostat, they understood that the update which they had given in the month of December, when the launch was done, update created a problem in the old air filters and the incompatible boiler. Later, when the Google identified this error, they again made a patch and they came up with a new update which they installed, and this solved most of the problems which was identified in the error which was there in the previous update. Now that was related to the room. Now this is another problem which occurred, that is in your co-op foods double charges. Now here the problem what happened was it created a very mass business failure. The problem was like the customers who ordered the food were charged for a double. That is, if you order for a single burger, the amount they paid was for the two burgers. Like similarly, anything they order in the organized, like from the store, the customers was charged the double the charges. Now the company had to incur a huge loss because the customer was very unhappy with this such failure, and they made sure that they paid back. But still, this glitch caused them a huge loss of losing their customers, for losing the belief in their company. Then the next failure which I would like to talk about is about the Tesco iPad pricing disaster. Now this Apple iPad was shown in one of the online site where it was shown for a free charge. That is a huge free charge with only the delivery payment, and the customers placed the request. So obviously an iPad, and later the organization realized that it was sold. It was a glitch in the software, and they had sold the Apple for free by costing only the delivery charges on a, you know, on a patch basis. What the customer, what the Apple company did was they requested the customer that it was a glitch, and they paid back the delivery charges and also offered them 20% discount for ordering in the next item. Okay, so that was one of the glitch. Now another one was a favorite. I think we have always used this Ola's and Uber's and all in our day-to-day life. Ola's mobile app, there was a glitch, and it allowed the users to book the rides for free. And Ola, being a very big company, incurred a huge loss with this, and they had to really work a lot to come out of that hack. And it was a great a problem for them to face such a problem in their mobile app. So this was related to Ola. Now Flipkart, how many of you used your Flipkart Billion Days? How many of you were aware about that, the one of the famous Flipkart Big Billion Days? Has anybody used during that time? Did anybody place an order in Flipkart Big Billion Days? Yes, no? You can use the chat button if you don't want to talk. Did anybody of you use the Flipkart, the first Flipkart Big Billion Days? No, the first time they launched. Any idea? Okay, so the problem with the Flipkart Big Billion Day was they never expected so much load onto their software. And it so happened when most of the customers logged in and most of the people logged in at the same time, due to the load, the Flipkart site just it just went blank, and then it was not able to handle the load, and it just panicked. And then the customers, but fortunately, Flipkart handled it in a very nice way, and they made sure that whatever the orders were placed were properly tracked, and they made sure that the deliveries were done, and any problem with the gateways were solved efficiently. But the problem here, what went, is about the load testing. Okay, so they somewhere misassumed the number of people that could log in at the same time, and hence that's what the major problem they faced was your load test. So coming to this, now whatever the case studies which I mentioned here, right? So all these were related to the business. Like I say, it could be related to the money, it could be related to the reputation of the company, it could be related to the financial loss, or it could be even related to your monetary loss and all. But the other two important things which I would like to mention, which I haven't put it in the PPT though, is about the cost of life, the cost of our people life and the cost of the people, the cost of living. Okay, one such case study was related to this car company, which was it was in US, and there was a couple who were driving in this automated car, and they were driving over a highway, and they were in a particular speed, and then they realized that their brakes had failed, and they were not applying the brakes, there was a failure. Now this car was belonging to a very reputed company, and it was a completely automated car, and when the brakes did not work, the couple were very panicked, and they immediately called up the emergency number. Now, you know the emergency number of the Americans, right? They just call the the American emergency number to get help, how to stop the car. Now, I see so many boys being there in the Google Meet, the students, right? So suppose you're driving a car and your brake failed. So what would you do? How would you try to save yourself? Could you give me some examples? How would you save? See, I'm not your faculty, okay? You don't have to worry. Even if you give me a wrong answer, I would be happy to know that, right? So boys, come on. So I would really like to know that if you're driving a car, I hope you're all drive a car. I'm sure you would have done that. So if your brake fails, what would you do? What would you do? Yeah. So I'll just pick up these people. Change the gear to Praveen. Very interesting. Change the gear to neutral. Yes, that's true. Stop the engine and down the gear slowly. Yes. Okay. And then? Praveen, very interesting. I think that is the first thing anybody would like to do, no? You try to change the gear and all. Apply handbrake. Very good. Yeah. Apply handbrake. Great. Next. it doesn't work. So as I told you, now this was an automated car. Now, what are the three answers which has come up? Praveen, Sudarshan, and Vidya Sagar. Yes, these are very usual common thing. Jump from the car. That was the last thing that we can do, right, Sudarshan? Yeah, jump from the car. That was the last thing which was left. Now, this automated car was in such a way that since they were in a very particular speed, as I told you, they had almost reached 100, and automatically there was a system in the car that the gear got locked and the steering was locked. Why I said steering is like one of the other method which you haven't mentioned here is to reduce the speed of the car. See, when you reduce the speed of the car, automatically the system would help them apply the brakes and change the gear and all. So they were trying to reduce the speed. So how do you reduce the speed of the car? You try to drive zigzag, right? You try to drive zigzag so that your car speed will come down. So that also they tried, but unfortunately the steering also was locked. Now this was a huge problem. They tried almost all options, and finally, like how Sudarshan mentioned, since they were a little middle-aged couple and they couldn't take an advantage of jumping away from the car, but they tried to on instruction from the police and the helpline, they made a accident, like a voluntary accident. That is, you go and hit some a tree or not safe accident, right? So they just went and hit a tree so that they could stop. It was a voluntary accident, but unfortunately the couple died in that accident. And since they had already called the helpline and the complete recording was the complete discussion among this couple as well as with the the organization was recorded. So this case was taken to the next level and the company was sued for having done such a big thing. And this code was transferred to the, the different departments to verify what went wrong. Okay. So it will be very, could you guess what could have gone wrong? Any idea what could have gone wrong? Wild guesses? Legal death. Yeah. Yeah. Right. Any guesses what could have gone wrong in the code? Where it could have gone wrong? Where it could have gone wrong? Just wild guesses. I know. When I say the error, you will be like, oh, really? Was this an error? Types, okay. Any wild guesses? Okay. So I'll just make this thing, okay. So the problem with the code was a very simple problem. That is, there was one line of a code which was used for testing during, unit testing of that particular fragment. And then the programmer who was working on that particular code had tested a code with that comment, with that line on the code, which made to check whether the loop was getting into a, infinite loop and it was going on, whether it is able to come out of the loop and all. So he was trying to check on that and he forgot to comment that. Okay, it was supposed to be a comment and he forgot to comment that. And the programmer left the job. And he had, and a new programmer had replaced that particular place, and he overlooked that error. And a simple problem, that is one line which was supposed to be comment, led to the death of two people. Isn't it scary? Right? So as well, like if you see like 20 years before or 30 years before, or like when probably forget about 10, 15 years when we started doing our computer engineering, it was not that, the software which we used was mostly related to your banks, libraries, the organizations and all. And we used to think like if I make an error, maximum it could be like some company will come across a loss. But see today where we are using mobile, I think we use the technology, the software every day. You sit with the software, you stand with the software, your home is equipped with the software, where you're using your smart rooms, smart ACs, smart TVs, smart mobiles. I think even one of the major thing we already know, right, the Samsung. Samsung also had this problem of, some blast was happening with the Samsung software also, right? So like that, even the smallest glitch can cost a person life. Okay, so this you should understand that being how responsible we software engineers should be when we are developing a code. It could be a simple code. How many of us, even when writing a simple program, we would have thought, why the comment is, what happens if I don't follow the clarity of the code? What happens if I don't give a thing, etc., and all. No, see, this can cause, even a smallest of the smallest mistake can cause. To touch upon that, one more last example I would like to give. Anybody are aware that there's a very huge saying, a man who saved the World War III, a man who saved the world from fighting a World War III. Any idea? Has anybody heard about that? Yes, no? So I just look into the chat. If you don't reply, I should consider it as no. No, okay. Thank you, Sudarshan, for that. Okay. So there was this, you know, this missiles and all the software. Yes, correct. Krishna, I think you are right. Would you like to tell about that? I would be really happy if you could tell from your own words. What did you understand with that? Yeah, Sudarshan? Not Sudarshan, I think. Sai Krishna, would you like to say about the case study? Sai Krishna? Plus one mark, shall I request your faculty to give you plus one mark for your continuous assessment so that you answer for me? Yeah? Okay. He denied to drop a bomb on us. Yes, why? What was that? Yes, correct. He denied to drop a bomb on us. Why? Why should we bomb? What happened actually? So are you people afraid to talk? Sudarshan sir? Srinivasan sir? Can the students talk?
Yes, madam.
Yeah.
So please be interactive.
I think... Sai Krishna is almost, he's just there, he's just perfect. So the students, I think whoever is interactive, no, you are going to get a very interesting gift from me. I'm going to send it to Srinivasan sir so that he will deliver that small memento for you people as a token of appreciation from my side for making my session interactive, right? Can I have it? He thought they may lead to bigger war and world war. No, why? What happened actually? I understood you're telling me that he made sure that the bomb was not dropped. But what was the situation which raised to drop a bomb? Why should we drop a bomb? Why did they think of dropping a bomb? The language. There is some. Yeah. Okay, very good. You're using the Google very well. Okay. Soviet new credited with preventing a Soviet nuclear strike. Yes, yes, yes. So what actually happened? I think you, Sudarshan, would you like to say that? I know you got it from Google, but I would really appreciate if you could put a small light on that. Just 2-3 seconds. What did you understand from that? No? You don't want to? Sudarshan or Sai Krishna? Anybody want? Okay, so this was, so they use this, you know, like the sensors and all to check what is happening in the action and all. So this software, which was identifying, you know, it accidentally thought that there is a missile being getting strike from the opposite station. So it just gave information to the army officials, to the Russians, saying that there is going to be an attack from the opposite country, so you should attack back. But fortunately, like how Sai Krishna meant, so the person made sure that he checked on the software. He had a doubt that the software could have told wrong. So the Russian captain, he just checked and the software had misinterpreted. And unfortunately, so that stopped us from the World War III. Great, thank you. So you all know now, right? So how important is about our the software testing, how the software code and all to be there. Yeah, great, thank you. So I know that you students have become very good after this pandemic of using Googles and all very well, right? So let us go forward, okay? So one of some of the errors which we saw and all. So just to give a brief overview before we enter into what is actually testing and we will do some small exercise and all. So If you look at now, if you take the statistics of 2019, which I took recently, the market size of your software is going to grow over 6% what you compare it from 2020 to 2026. Why is it going to grow? Is because an increased use of the mobile applications, the increased incorporation of artificial intelligence and machine learning into many of our everyday day-to-day lives, and lot of opportunities for the people to come up with a huge number of applications and huge number of smart system which is going to come into the market. And hence obviously the software testing also becomes equally important, because it is anything which is related to your embedded system software, it again becomes an important one. When I say artificial intelligence, machine learning, IoT, cloud, etc., whatever I mean to say, now obviously there's a lot of innovative approaches which is used in the software development. When I use innovative approaches in the software development, your software in testing also should involve a lot of innovative approaches. Now, how do I involve that is another huge this one. So if you see the traditional software development life cycle, it is meant that the software testing will happen only at the end of the software development life cycle. But now, after involving your agile methodologies, it is almost called as a test driven development, right? You heard about test driven development. That is, from the time you start collecting the requirements from your customer, you start testing. That is, have you understood the your requirements clear? Have you understood the client's perspective clear? Have you designed it well? Is the prototype correct? And then with all your specification only, you enter into the the development, and then obviously acceptance, beta and all, which your faculty would have told it in a very complete manner and all. Now, just to touch upon, we'll do a small exercise, okay? Why we should do testing about the requirements, okay? There are two examples. One, I will come with a detailed example later in the stage, but here I would like to do a small exercise, okay? Again, a small exercise. Now, we all are, I think I've already taken an example of a car, so we will continue with the car itself. There's a one small interest about me in the cars is because I have my husband who works for an automobile company, so I can understand more and more case studies, you know? So I can understand and put it forward, like, is it right? So can I use this for my software? You know, a lot of testing and all happens. So that's the reason I am very much oriented towards your cars and all. Okay, now just imagine I'm your customer, okay? I'm your customer and I come to you and you are going to sell a car to me. Okay, all the students, you are all my people who are going to sell a car to me. I come and tell you, could you please suggest me affordable car, affordable car, which is very good quality. Okay, or you can say, I say, I want a car with a very best quality and an affordable rate. So could you please suggest me some cars? Can you just put it on the chat box? So what do you suggest? Which car should I buy? Which car should I buy? Tata Safari, okay. Sudarshan says Tata Safari. Others? So you're all my people, okay? You're going to suggest a car. Just think like you are prediction algorithms you're using or recommendation algorithms you're developing, okay? Can you recommend a car for me? Okay, Innova, okay, Corolla Altis, Verna, okay. Somehow, whether I'll buy a car or not, Vidya Sagar chose my favorite one. Verna is one of my favorite car. Software design, because it is affordable and cost efficient. Okay, Vishal, very nicely put, Vishal. So that will be okay. I did give you my requirements. Can you, Chakresh, would you like to know more about my requirements? You can ask me a question if you want to understand. Sudarshan, Honda City, yes. Tata Nano, okay. I think Nano is no more producing, right? Is it in production? Yeah, Chakresh, you can ask me a question. What type of requirement would you like to know? Lamborghini, okay. So Sudarshan is recommending me on a basis of, 1, 2, 3. So ma'am, you can go for this, you can go for that, you can go for that. Tata Diago, budget range. I said it is an affordable. So I come from, I want something affordable. Tesla. Okay, Bugatti. Okay. If not Bugatti, then what? If not Bugatti, okay. If not all those, whatever you suggest, I can go for Bugatti. Okay. Right, any more cars? I don't see girls participating at all. Only the boys? Yeah. Okay. You could go for Brisa. Yeah, one of the very nice cars. Okay. Rolls Royce. No. So girls don't have interest on the cars, really? Renault Duster. Go to Renault Duster. Okay, Sudarshan has a wide idea about your cars. Jeep Compass. Praveen wants me to drive a Jeep. Okay. Raven Swift. Okay, you love that. Okay, you love the car. That is, you love a Renault Duster, is it? Okay, nice. Okay, so the boys are very, very interactive. Okay, thank you so much. So Thar, yeah, Thar is one of my favorite. Yes. Okay, great. Good, excellent, wonderful. Now, why do you, so can I see, so many of you suggested me in a wide range of cars, right? From sedan, to SUV, to XUV, four-seaters, two-seaters, three-seaters, and all. Somewhere Chakresh was trying to be a little more specific. He wanted to know the requirement more specifically, though they did not ask me the question. Yes. Now, whenever a client is talking to you, when he mentions some vague things, you know, Nexus, yes, Monica, finally. Okay, nice, Monica. So whenever a client is trying to give you a requirement, and if it is vague, okay, there is a chance that you misinterpret, right? So like how I said, affordable. What do I mean by affordable? What do you think, according to you, is an affordable cost for me? When I say I want to buy a car in an affordable cost, what did you assume? How much money would I like to spend on? How much money would I like to spend on? Yeah. Just put it in lakhs, okay? How much do you think is an affordable clause according to me? Around 10 lakhs, okay. 5 minimum, okay. 5 to 20. Raven, that was a, again, your requirement itself is vague. 5 to 20 lakhs. 5 is here, 20 is there. Is it 5 or 20? 15 to 20, okay. 5 to 10, okay. Okay, good. Right? Very good. So this is what you assumed, and definitely you mentioned me according to that. Yes, sir. So according to me, maybe when I say an affordable cost for me, just to put it on the records here. So I would, when I say affordable from my side, I would like to go for 10 to 15 lakhs. Okay. So whatever the cost you suggested me below 10 lakhs, or above 15 lakhs, I wouldn't have taken your car because you did not try to understand me better, right? And similarly, when I say a quality car, when I say a quality car, a quality is again a very, very vague term, right? So how do I test the quality? What do I mean the quality? You mean to say that Nano, because it is 1 lakh car, it is not a quality car? And if it is a Benz, you pay a lot of money, it's a quality car? No. Right? So there are some minimum quality constraints, minimum testing things which has to be done for any vehicles to come on road, right? It has to follow the guidelines and then come on road. But how much you pay is what extra you pay is what an extra added features and extra quality attributes and extra testing and extra thing which you get from your cars. That's why the cost of the cars vary. Okay, so that was an example to give you about. Yes, yeah, yes, take a test drive and check the test, correct? But that acceptance, you see, like if you check, very true, but then if you are asking me to take a test drive, probably I would like to see that my car is going on a particular speed, is it comfort for me, is there enough boot space in for me, am I able to sit properly, am I able to reach the steering comfortably, all these only I can see. But technically there can be a glitch which acceptance testing cannot be done, but other things can be done. Okay, since you touched upon that point, some example could be airbags. All of us know how airbags work. Yes, no? How does airbag, what is an airbag in a car? Since you talked to about test drive, what's an airbag? How does it work? Yes, and what has happened? To avoid major damage to the skull, that is, so your car is provided in the, like based on the version. So you go and hit some particular distance with some, particular speed and particular huge accident or something, the airbag will come so that you don't hit and it saves you from the damage. Perfect. Yes, correct. Correct, Revanth. So that is what I was trying to tell. So see, if your software, now this is completely a software, right? What does the software do? You have a software in the ECU unit. There's something called electronic controller unit into your car, which has a sensor. Now this sensor will be checking at what speed. You know, there are some attributes which it check, like what speed your car is going on and what you know, pressure you actually, what is the intensity of the accident which has happened between the person, like your car and the thing, and what, some 5-6 attributes, whatever is there, and based on that it will decide whether the airbag should release or not. Because even for the smallest of the smallest accident, if the airbag release, then I have to spend a lot of money to again correct it, so I wouldn't be very happy. Only if the accident is a very huge one and if it is a really necessary one, only then the airbag has to come. Now that again is the software is the one which is going to do deal that. So I need to test to make sure that software is testing well and it has to work well. Okay, suppose if I wasn't in the lockdown situation and not at home, if I'm in the university, I would have shown you an example of how this embedded software testing works. Okay, probably sometime in the next semester when the lockdown is gone and all, probably I can give you one session on that also. Okay, so I think we've talked enough about your examples of your, now let us go into this one. Okay, so this is a triangle test. So as per my knowledge, and I was looking into the syllabus which you have gone across in your thing, you have learned about the testing techniques and you have learned about your testing principles, etc., 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 and all. Now I want you to take up this small exercise. It's called as a triangle test. Okay, so you are given with a simple program. You're supposed to test for a simple program. Now this program will accept 3 integers. Okay, so either as an input or an argument, you can pass it either as an input or an argument. Now this integer will represent the length of the triangle side. Okay, so it has to give 3 sides. Okay, the length of the triangle's 3 sides. Okay, so based on the input, that is the 3 arguments which I'm going to pass, it has to test whether the given triangle is an equilateral, isosceles, or a scalene. Okay? So this is your small program. Now, what I want you to put it in the chat button is, I want you to write an effective and efficient set of test cases. Now, when I say effective, that means it should find the common bugs also. Okay. Because effective means I have to touch upon all the side, and if I say efficient, that means you have to think a little out of the box. Other than the common errors, what are all the test cases that can be identified? Okay, so you can put it to me in this template: test action and data. That is, what is the input I'm going to give, and what will be the result? What should be the result? Okay, so to give on a hint, I want you to work is, you can use black box testing technology, that is your equivalence class partitioning and boundary value analysis. Okay, you can use the technique of boundary value analysis or equivalence class partitioning. Can you put down at least 2 to 3 test cases? I'll give you the answer, don't worry. I just want to know how much you're going to do. Right, can we have some test cases put up? I give you some, yeah, you definitely need some time. So I'm giving you 5 minutes. Okay, the test cases are there. Just take a gap and then tell me. Okay, I've given you a hint. So there are 3 types of triangle over there. That is your scalene, isosceles, and equilateral triangle. And you are supposed to send 3 inputs. Now I told you an effective test case. Effective test cases are easy. These are remember and understand. You just have to put, that is to give more hint, you can give an input which cannot form a triangle at all. Okay. Not form a triangle at all, which is neither an equilateral triangle. It could be an equilateral triangle, it could be an isosceles. What type of input if I give that I can consider that as an equivalence? Try. I'm waiting for 5 minutes. Let me see. One test case, one each of you, even if you put, I'll be really happy to know. One small test case. So the next one, Srinivasan sir, for the next activity, I'm going to use you. So please be ready, okay? Sir, you're going to participate in my game, okay, for the next one. So by the time the students, okay, so the students, if you really feel you don't want to give the test cases, okay, so this is, oh yeah, very good, Praveen, nice. 516 is invalid, not a triangle, excellent. 555 is valid because it's an equilateral triangle. 56 effective test cases, excellent, Praveen. You have come up with an effective test cases. I'm impressed. Very nice. Any other test cases? Yeah. This can be even a challenge. It's like an open book quiz. You can even Google it up. I don't mind. You can even Google it up. Okay. So you can be doing it. The others can. In the meanwhile, we'll go to the one. So as I told you, coming to your, just come back to that later. Now, after knowing that, you know, the reason behind having so many problems and so many things and all, how do I make my software testing insights better? The first one is I have to establish the channels for cross-functional communication. That is, I need to understand the multidisciplinary way of communication across the departments, across the people, across the different type of clients. One example which I want to show it in the presentation is, I don't know how many of you have seen this example. Have you looked at this one somewhere? The swing example, the famous swing example. Should I zoom it for you a little? Yeah. Is it visible?
Yes, madam.
Yeah. So, students, I want you to please see, if you remember the car example, whatever I spoke, it exactly touches on that point. You can see, how the customer explained it. See, actually, if you see the picture 1 and picture 12, now the customer wanted a swing exactly what was there in the picture 12. Okay. That is, he wanted a swing which has to be designed exactly at 12. But when he was trying to tell his requirement to the requirement engineer, he mentioned the requirements in the point 1. Okay. Now, how did the project leader understood that? See, he understood this way. Now, the software testing has completely failed. I have not used requirement-based testing here. Now, how the analyst designed? The project leader went and told the analyst. Okay. Now, what did the programmer do? Okay, see in the fourth slide, what did the programmer do? Who are the beta testers? What do you mean by beta testers? Beta testers are the one who are going to test your software at the customer site, right? They directly go to the customer site and they want to know, okay? So these are the beta testers, that is on site. When the testing went, this is what was there. Does this look like a swing? I feel it looks like a suicide thread, right? Now see the business consultant, how diligently he described it, okay? And see the documentation on the seventh part, how it was documented. There was nothing, no information was documented properly. And what operations was installed? And see the amount of payment, how the customer was costed, okay? And the maintenance was very poor in the 10th slide. And the advertisement, very beautifully they advertised. Okay, do you understand where is the gap? Yeah, yes, no? So this is what happens when you don't involve your testing in a better way, okay? So the well-defined reports, yes. Now how do I remove the communication barriers? Okay, how do I remove the communication barriers? So in your organization or when you are working across the teams, it is very much necessary that you understand and your client well, and you notice on every moment what they're doing, or your customer or your analyst or your designer, what he's trying to talk to you, what he's trying to tell you, all those things has to be clear. For that, now Srinivasan sir is going to help me, right? Sir, could you please pitch in inside?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, can I have your video on? Now, a small exercise for you. I'm sure the students know you very well. That's the reason I wanted you to be involved in this game. So I want you to tell three things, okay? There should be two truths and a one lie, okay? You have to tell a three statement. You're going to tell three statements to this to all of us, in which there will be two true statements and one lie statement, okay? Please keep the video on throughout when you're telling the statement. Now, after listening to all the three statements, the participants can tell me which statement was actually a lie. Okay. Yeah. So you got it right. I hope you got it. Yeah. So when you're ready, you can tell me, sir. You have to just tell me three statements. Anything. No technical and all. You can just tell about yourself. Random thing. Three things you're going to do. It could be about your hobby. It could be about your way you are there in the college. It could be about something you eat, something you see, something you watch, something you do, anything. Or what would have happened now, what is the situation, anything. Three statements you're going to tell me, in which two truths should be there, one lie should be there. But the participants have to tell me which is a lie, okay? So let us give some time for sir to come up with that.
Okay.
Okay. Ready, sir?
Okay, madam.
Okay. Okay. Now, participants, yes, listen to Srinivasan, sir. Yes, sir. I'll also try. Yeah.
Okay. I tell three statements about corona disease. The first statement is corona vaccination help us by protecting from corona disease. So vaccination help us by protecting from corona. Second one, vaccination is available to all people.
Okay.
Statement.
Okay.
Corona is one of the most dangerous disease.
Mm-hmm. Very good, sir. I didn't expect you were going to be so tricky. The questions are very tricky. So just concentrate, and if you have the knowledge, you're going to put it up. So I hope you, sir. Okay. Second one. No, you have to be very specific. What? Which one? Second one. Praveen. Which second one? It is available to all of them. So the don't reveal. Don't reveal.
Okay.
Okay. It is available to all the one, right?
Oh, yes.
Available to all. Okay. Praveen says the second one is a lie. How about others? Sir was very good. He took an important topic, which is in news every day. So I don't think anybody vaccination is available. Okay. Monica also thinks the second one is a lie. Okay. Others, fast. Second one is a lie. Is there anybody who thinks vaccination is available? 2 to 18, they're still testing for age group 2 to 18. Okay. Yeah. Praveen, vaccination is available. Okay. Everybody feels? Okay. They bumped in. They know. Okay. When it is security, validity, they're all jumped in. When I ask about cars, they were very quite good. Okay, sir. Now you can tell me what, according to you, is a lie.
Of course, the second statement.
Yes, good.
The vaccination is not available to all.
Correct. So see, that was very interesting. No, when I say all the people, fortunately, if I am looking at it, no, I would have thought like when I say all, yeah, everybody above 18 was available. It is available to all. That could have been statement. Yes, Praveen has put it right. When I say all, it is not yet been produced for the people who are under 18. That is, the kids group is still at the testing process. Okay, what led to this? That is, you are having an information about, now sir took a very general topic, that is, he's mentioning about the happening. So if you are understanding the news which is happening around, you can correlate and decide what is a lie statement, what is a correct statement, right? Now, I'm going to be a little personal. Now I'm going to tell, now I'm a complete stranger for you, right? You don't know me at all. Now, I've kept my video on so that when I'm making a statement, you can look at me also. Now, I'm going to make three statements, okay? Come on, you can tell me now what is lie and what is true, okay? So I have been married for 10 years and have two children. I don't like eating, I don't like eating pumpkin, and I love traveling. Yeah. So I hope you got all my three statements. So it is completely about me. Okay, I'm your client. So what do you think is a lie according to me? You can put it in the chat button. First one is a lie. Okay. No idea. No, you can try. No, I know you shouldn't have idea. But I'm obviously I'm a complete stranger. You wouldn't have known about me. You can try. By the way I expressed, by the way I told the information, you should know. First statement is a lie. Okay. Yeah, so third one is a lie. So that is I love traveling. That is a lie. Okay. Then, so I think two of them feel, maybe the second one. Okay, Praveen. Okay. Saranya. Okay, Saranya and Praveen, why do you think the second one is wrong? What made you think the second one is wrong? Okay, those people are telling first one is lie. Can you just tell me why did you think? If you small reason. Okay. 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 You don't want to say, okay. You took more time. Yeah. Wonderful. I took more time to tell that. Huh? Okay. Yeah. Okay. Very fact. Actually, I'm very happy that you've given me a compliment that the first one is lie. Okay. I have been married for 11 years, actually 10 to 11. I'm going to complete my 11 years and I do have two children. Okay. So first one is true. Second one is wrong. Yes, Praveen, and one more person got it right. I don't like eating pumpkin. You know, the way I was telling it, I was taking my own time and I was stressing on the point saying that I don't like eating pumpkin. Like, see that reaction and the stress I'm giving you? That is, I'm making it clear to you that my intention is not, I don't like it. So please concentrate on that. So why I'm trying to tell this is, see, it is not necessary that always whatever you see or whatever you perceive may be true. Okay, even with it in the program, everything will look fine. But what is wrong is what we don't know. Okay, so for that, one was this a non-technical example I gave you, right? That is by looking at an expression or by looking at the program and all. Now we are going to do one small technical exercise. After this, I'm not going to make you do any exercise. I know you're going to curse me for making you do so many exercises, but let me do this, okay? So, small exercise. Before doing that exercise, as I told you, it is very important to understand where a fault is, how an error has been occurred, and what's a failure. Now, before we do that in your testing, now these three plays a very important role in your testing. Why I name this particular thing as an insights of software testing is, usually we learn so many things like black box, case studies, that, this, and all, but we forget about the basic foundation where we actually go wrong with your testing. That's the reason I wanted to put it up. This is a major topic to make you understand why testing is very important and how do you identify that, okay? Now, what's a fault? That is, it could be any defect which is there in the software, like it could be incorrect lines of code, or it could be anything, whatever happens. It could be a variable error, if the declaration error, or the initialization error, I wrote an incorrect statement, whatever it could be, all those comes under the fault. Now, what's an error? An error is something which is caused a incorrect internal state. That is, for example, I say, I wanted to add two numbers, but it did not add two numbers. I wanted it to enter into a particular loop. It did not enter into the loop. I wanted it to exit after that particular condition. It did not exit that after that particular condition. Now that is called as an error. Now what's a failure? A failure is the one which I am able to identify it. That is, for example, if I say there is a fault which has been executed and an error has come, but in the output, the failure I couldn't identify. Now that becomes your failure. Now these type of things which cause a major challenge to the testers. That is, there is a fault, there is an error which has been caused, but the failure never happened. Okay. So hence your test case did not reveal and your test cases were not efficient, and hence it led to this problem. Okay. Now for that, a simple example, as the time is running out, I'll directly go to this example. Can you just look into this code? A small four program I've put. A small. Okay. If you see this, you can see what I've written is I have given an int count is equal to 0. For int I is equal to 1, okay, for int I is equal to 1, I less than x point, that is the length of your x, and then I increment I plus plus. And if x of I is equal to 0, it has to tell me, it has to increment the counter. That is why the increment the counter, because if you see the comment, it says how many times the 0 has occurred in that particular array. X is what I want the answer for. Okay, so that is the thing here. Now, if you see what is the problem here is, if you see the counter, what is the problem here? I think already the output is there, but can you just tell me what is the counter here? What's the error here? Any idea? What's the error here? Yes, correct, Praveen. The start index, what should have, it should have been? What should have to be? It should have been I is equal to, I think there was a clue there, no? It was in the red one. So what should it have been? Yes, correct. Now what happened? Now I will tell you, correct. Now I'll tell you what can go wrong here. Now I am a tester, okay? Now I am a tester and I've asked you to test this particular loop. Now I'm going to give a test case. What is the test case I've given? 270. Okay, how many zeros are there in this particular array? How many zeros are there in particular array? 1. Now, when I execute this test case in the program, definitely it will give me an answer 1. Definitely it will give me an answer 1 only, because it will go till 3 and give me the answer. Okay, forget about what is written there, right? Because if the 0 is available in the third position, obviously it will go till there and it will tell me, yes, the output is correct and it will give me. Now, suppose I pass an array which is 0 to 7. Okay, I'll tell you the difference. I'm putting it in the, yes. So I'll tell you. So if I'm passing this test case, that is 270, then my output will be correct. Okay, even if I pass 28098. So just look into the chat button. I'm putting some test cases. Can you tell me what will happen? Whether error will be executed, fault will be executed? That is what I want you to tell me. 2, 3. Okay. If you see the first one, 270. Okay. In this case, the error has been executed because the loop has gone inside and it has been executed, but the fault is not identified. That is, your failure does not come because it has given me the exact count 1 and it won't show me an error. Now, in the second case, also the same thing. It will, since the 0 is not present in the first position, it will definitely show me the right one. Okay, the number of occurrences. It's not giving me an index position. It will tell me 1, 0 is available. But if you see in the third case, that is, if I am a tester and I've only tested my loop with the first two conditions, then obviously my test case will not identify the fault which was there in the loop. But then if I would have sent a test case, which is x is equal to 0, 2, 3, definitely the failure would have come and it would have not recognized the error 0 and I would have gotten incorrect behavior. In that case, my test case would have been more effective and it would have been helpful for me to identify that the error has been identified and it has to be corrected. Now, why I'm telling you this example is the effective way of testing is very important. Okay, the error could be anything. Okay, I will share this PPT with you people. So usually, now this is a fault and all. Now, if you see here, this is an erroneous state. That is, there is a error between the bridge, right? Now, this is because of the, you're going to track that. This is because of the design fault. Instead of putting the track left, they have put it to the right, right? And mechanical fault. It just did whatever the design was given, right? So that is what I meant to this. So what is the model which you have to follow is, you have to make sure that you follow a RIP model, which is your reachability, infection, and propagation. That is nothing but whenever you are testing a particular code, you have to make sure that exactly where the fault is there, whether I'm able to reach that particular fault with the help of my test case. Once I've understood that the fault has been reached, then I have to see where exactly it is infecting, whether it is infecting in the output, whether it is not allowing me to go into the loop, whether it is not allowing to do, that is your infection. Now, what is the propagation? By infecting this particular state, whether my answer is going to be identified or not. So what happened? That's why we say sometimes my program may have a lot of errors, but my customer may not able to, he will never come across that error at all. So I'm very safe, okay? But unfortunately, even if one of the error has been gone without my sight and it goes to the customer site and he identifies it first, that means my testing is being inefficient, okay? So that is about your RIP model, okay? So I hope you got the point that how important it is to identify your errors, okay? So always you need to make sure that when you're addressing your fault at different stages, that you try to avoid, detect. First thing is you should try to avoid, okay? How do you avoid? You make a better design, you make a better programming logic, use test-based development and all. Suppose you were not able to avoid, then you go for fault detection. Now, what is fault detection? That is your testing and debugging. Now, testing and debugging are different, right? Debugging is actually you're going to go and correct the error. Probably would have done in your C program, right? You go check, trace back and correct your error. Now, what is fault tolerance? Even though there is a error which is there in your software or which is there in your program which has gone unidentified, then you're going to make sure that your system becomes fault tolerant. That is, the error is isolated. It doesn't disturb the regular activities of your program. Though there is a small error and all, it should not become a major glitch. Okay. So that is what you need to make sure that you address. Okay. So with that, I just want to give you a last small topic. I know I've taken a little bit extra time. So much after, what I want you to, if you're really interested into software quality or testing, as I have, as I was telling you, before I joined academics, I had been working on a software testing platform in an corporate thing. So I was working on an automation testing. So if you really want to grow up your career into the software quality assurance, now it is no more software testing. It is called verification, validation, quality assurance, etc., etc. So the top five things which you should put your interest on is to automate. There are a huge number of automation tools which are available. Probably in the future of any sessions we get, we can completely concentrate on automation tools like your QTP, which is the latest version, which is nothing but unified testing protocol, testing tool, Selenium, which is an open source tool, load testing, the embedded testing. There are a huge number of testing tools which are available, which you can incorporate, especially when you're talking about regression testing and all, and try to move your testing and software into the cloud. Why to the cloud? Because of the huge database which is there, right? There's a huge data which is being collected. Your systems are growing large. You need to have a lot of space. You need to have a lot of software to be installed. So you can use the opportunity which is available where like Microsoft Azure is available, the Google Ops are giving so a lot of options. So just you can try to work on how to test on cloud. Okay, so that is one of the important, very, very trending techniques which is there in your software testing. And look for answers in the testing data. That is usually most of our output which lies is falls into your arguments, you know, the test data which we give. As I told you, how you're going to give the test data will make a thing. So there's a huge number of research which is happening on how to prioritize your test cases, how to identify the right test case, how to help the you know, the project manager decide how many test cases has to be done. So all those things you can work on, a huge you know, trend on that, like recommendation, prediction, prioritization and all. And then good testing standards. Yes. So if you really want to know about the standards, there is something called, since I was talking about your automobiles, so the automobiles, whenever you are developing a particular software for your automobile, that is your embedded software, they need to stick on to particular standards called MISRA, okay, MISRA, MISRA standards, or ISO standards, as well as your CERT standards, CERT, CERT standards. Now, these standards are the one, if they're going for C, C++, usually embedded, where they go for C, C++ code and all. Nowadays, Python is slowly jumping in, but if you see on a larger scale, C and C++ is the one which is highly used in the embedded software. So CERT and MISRA standards are the ones which are very important. Now, these standards, when you are developing your program, you need to follow these standards, whether it is related to the number of comments available, the clarity, the amount of code, how many loops you have, whether you have a go-to statement, whether you have left the loop The main not designed, all those things will be clearly mentioned until and unless you your code doesn't fit onto that standard and the tool doesn't say that your code is clear, you cannot put it into the real-time application. So you can work on these testing standards, a huge scope for that, and then focus is the key. As I told you, as a software tester, it's very important for me to understand from every perspective, you know, because you're questioning somebody, you're trying to break the system. So you should not be positive. When I say you should not be positive, that is, you should not think the system will always work. You should always think the system will not work. How will I make people understand that the system has failure? Okay, so that is what a software tester should focus on. I should always see what is the system, how the system is going to be broken. If I'm developing a particular software, how the people would like to break the software, what can go wrong? That is the how I should think. When I'm thinking in that way, I'm following a slightly different approach. So obviously your focus is very important, whether it is deceiving or looking at the people or listening to their comments, being more specific, following a proper documentation, using of technologies, using of automation, whatever it is, you need to make sure that you have your own focus. Okay, so with that, I would like to stop the presentation. I think it's been over. I'm so sorry if I have made you work a lot. I hope the session was interactive enough for you to understand. I'm open to take questions. If you would like to know something, you can pop in with your questions. And even if you want any other topic which I want me to share, like the presentations or the softwares or any sites which you have to look into, you can definitely get back to me. And those who are interested in pursuing your research or you want some ideas where you want to continue, that also you can always reach back to me, right? I'm open to the questions.
Feel free to ask questions. Do you have any questions?
You want to know more about something? Okay, should I put it like one question good enough? Were you able to get something, some point, like at least 10% of things, if you can take back and change your insight about software testing, I would be really happy about that. You can even share your feedback to sir so that he will let me.
Okay, fine, madam.
Yeah.
I think if you have any questions, you send it to me so that
yes,
forward it to the madam.
Yes, sir.
So we come to the last part of this session. See, I thank Anubhava madam for giving wonderful insight of software testing through many real-time examples. So I hope you have enjoyed the examples. It is clearly visible through your interaction.
Yeah. So yes, sir. Sorry to interrupt you, sir. Actually, you know, please make down. I may forget the names, right? So probably I really want to appreciate some of the students, like Sudarshan, I believe. Sudarshan, and there's one more student who was regularly active. Okay, I just get in touch with you. Please do give them. I will be sending them a small token of appreciation and making it interesting for my class. So please do make sure that you give it up to them.
Definitely, madam. We will pass on it to them. Thanks for your participation. And I thank madam once again on behalf of our college, our department, and our faculty members. Thank you again, ma'am. Students, you wait the. Is he here?
Yeah. Thank you so much, madam. Thank you, sir. So I can leave, right?
Yes,
thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Thank you, madam. You are welcome. So I put the attendance link in our chat box. So please fill it up. Jay Kumar sir.